They're fine. Hey, they're just watching right here. All right, guys, nice and calm when you come up here. Excuse me. Problems get real worrying right there. It's guys. It's a little grumpy.
Autobots, transform and roll out. Where are you, Megatron? I have returned. And I am finding out that you have been terrorizing these humans yet again, Megatron. Face me now, Decepticon coward, once and for all. Ready for action? Aerodynamic Shane Skull, ready to cut through the space-time continuum.
Hi, Shannon. Say hi to Shannon.
Hi, Shannon.
Oh, thank you. Very good. We're at Hogwarts! I have no idea if it actually showed it to you, but we're Harry Potter World at Universal Studios.
People!
Shame on those people for not just ducking under the railing and to come and walk by us. Jerks. Anyway, so our passes expire tomorrow, so we're here for one more time, because we're going to let them go until after the summer. So, yeah. Last Butterbeer, last Chocolate Frog.
For a few months.
Come Forever.
On. It's not like it's gonna
I'm
like...
I'm gonna cry! Okay, for a few months.
Yeah.
He wasn't going to be crazy old Maurice. He was going to be this painter, essentially. And I was like, that inventor thing, that would be really cool for Belle. And so, you know, Belle and I were passionate about this storyline that she creates this washing machine in order that she then has more time to read for herself. And actually, in our story, that she becomes an activist in her own community and tries to teach other girls to read.
So we started on the ground, and then I graduated to the stilts, and did, you know, we learned the dance all over again, the 10 inches off the ground, and it's a pretty good way to get to know your co-star, being thrown in to waltz lessons on day one, especially when your co-star
thinks... So much trust. So much trust on my part.
Break your toes.
Yeah, he has literally steel stilts on. So if we had messed up, which there was a chance, that we might do that in the number of takes we did this in. I could lose a toe, I could have broken a foot. It was, and I loved the role reversal of so much of the movie, because usually I'm the one in the heels being like, oh, will you like hold my arm? And in this situation, I was like, I've got you.
Two or three takes, and then the suit would get so hot that I would have to be plugged in. They made a special cooling vest, like Formula One racing drivers wear, and around the back of the beast's butt was a fundament or something, I don't know, an outlet, a pipe was poking out, which they would connect to a box of ice cold water, and I would, my heart rate would be brought down to a sort of humanly safe level, and then we'd go again.
Hi, Shannon.
Hello.
We just saw Beauty and the Beast.
Hey, look at that, the lighting even worked.
And it was really good, like amazing. I had high hopes for it, but it surpassed them a lot. I cried like 5 times just because of how perfect it was, so. Yeah, go see it.
15 hours of prep to do this video.
What are you doing?
We're gonna do 15 hours of prep.
What are you talking
There's
about?
There's a lot going on right
James,
now.
What are you doing? What are you talking about?
We're recording a video.
Okay, we're not doing 15 hours of prep.
Just to record this video.
No, we're ready now.
Oh, we're ready now?
Yeah.
Okay, let's go.
Okay. Hi. We're here to watch Beauty and the Beast for the second time.
On opening night.
On opening night. And I'm very, very, very excited because I love this movie. And I've been waiting for this for how many days? Like 10 days? Over
782 over days.
No, but it feels like it. So, yay! So something else happened today that I wanted to tell you about on Twitter, which is that, what's that face for, James?
That's my anticipation face.
Oh, okay. Anyway, so Josh Gad was, what are you doing? Oh, yes, Josh Gad, a.k.a. Olaf, a.k.a. LeFou, tweeted that if you send him a picture of your tickets to Beauty and the Beast for like 10 minutes, he was sending out personal video responses. So I sent a picture of my tickets along with my little mini LeFou, and he sent a personal video response to me and said my name.
Yes, Beth, that is awesome. Always good to have an additional Josh Gad prop in front of you when showing me your tickets. That'll get you extra points for sure. Enjoy the film.
And I freaked the heck out for like an hour. I was like running around the house screaming.
Luckily, I wasn't there to witness this.
I wasn't quite running around the house screaming, but
I'm pretty sure she was.
It was close enough. I watched like 10 times and made like a weird high-pitched noise after every single time.
I think the accurate term would be fangirling.
I was fangirling hardcore because I love him and he's beautiful. No offense, James. You're beautiful too. Okay. Hi, Shannon. We're at Disneyland. James. James, stop being creepy. James.
I'm being a statue.
Stop being a statue.
I was frozen.
That's the wrong movie.
Oh,
it's not Frozen Day. It's Beauty and the Beast Day. We're going to do everything at Disneyland that's related to Beauty and the Beast. And then we're going to go see the movie for the fifth time. Because one of us is obsessed. I guess that would be me. He's just along for the ride. You like the movie though, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Hello, it's me.
I got a rose cake pop.